So, hello everyone, this is Kushal and we will be seeing some machine learning algorithm explanation videos in this. Like in my videos, you'll be seeing videos like this. And this is a video explaining support vector machines algorithm in which today we'll be seeing a basic intuition about it. So it is a part of a video series in which we'll be seeing a basic introduction today. So let's start. Like if we have to start something, we have to assume something. So first thing to assume is, let's assume we are a road contractor. Okay, so we have got a road. So let's assume that we are a road contractor and we have to make a road. So we have made a road that looks something like this, and let me color it black because roads are black. So yeah, now what we have to do, we have to make a margin in between of this road, because every road has got a margin in between that looks something like this. And this margin classifies the traffic, in which one traffic goes in this direction and another part of traffic goes in this direction. So like we have to make this middle margin. So how will we make that? How will we get those center middle exact coordinates to make this center middle dotted line? So to get those center coordinates, we need to have two reference points in the left and right side of the roads to actually get those center coordinates. So we'll make two reference lines in the end that will look something like this, and another one will look something like this, and then we'll be making a margin like this, and then we'll be getting the center coordinate, and then we'll be passing the middle dotted line by that margin, and that's how we'll be creating a margin and road, and that's how we'll finish our task. Now let's connect this dividing problem to our support vector machines algorithm, which is a similar sort of problem inspired by a road problem. So let's see. So let's assume we have got male and female voices data set in which we are plotting their pitches in this graph. So as we all know that male voice has got low pitch and female voice has got high pitch. So I'm plotting the male voice's pitches here, which won't go too much high because males have got low pitch. So that will lie somewhere around in this region. So this is what male region is. And let me plot now female voices. So female voices will be going somewhere in the higher story or whatever if you want to call it. So they'll go somewhere around here. So these are female voice pitches and those are male voice pitches. Now what we have to do, we have to classify this data set. We have to plot a standard middle classification line between it, and to do that we need to actually see this problem as our road classification problem again. So what we'll be doing is we'll be making two outer margins like this, and those outer margins will be just touching the outermost data point of both the male and female data set. So one margin with one reference line will look something like this, and another reference line will look something like this. So this is our road, and we need to make that center margin to make that center margin. We'll get the distance between both of these, and then we'll be maximizing the distance with two constraints that these two margins. We'll be seeing that in future videos, but this is just a basic intuition. So what we'll be doing is we'll be making a center margin at the center coordinate like this, and that will classify the data set very very precisely. So if in near future if there is a test data set so let's assume that center data point will lie somewhere around like somewhere here, so our center line will classify that as female voice, and if it will lie somewhere around here, then it will be classified as male. So we have to create that center bound so that we can classify any any pitch of a voice as male or female voice. So that will like that will be a generalized boundary that can be used in any use for any data, and like we have to train our algorithm on a simple data set. So we'll be seeing in future videos how to train, how to code, how to do like everything in support vector machines. So stay tuned for that, and thanks for watching.